at the time, but it's the reason I'm rich. Never see me knocking nobody, I know how hard it can get. Respect whoever on they, cause you be in your zone when you in it. On your own when you in it. Wake up, look out the window, see the rose in the Bentley when you in it. Cause it reeks. Oh boy, it's so much to see. Gotta learn to keep your balance. Going to sleep on silk sheets, but it used to be a pallet. Fell in love with shopping, I'm getting a grip of it. I don't need no stylist. Walking on Mars, spin a bag on anything if it got me smiling. I'm on every L that I ever took, I promise. Flashy with a sis on, man, I don't look, that's how I'm coming. Can't wait to touch a meal like I ain't got no food inside my tummy. Been had a vision, seen it vividly before it got sunny. You could tell I'm committed. This get hard and I get it, but long as you stay authentic, you'll be destined to win it. I recreated my image. This was earned, never given. Gonna be that way till it's finished. Cause you be in your zone when you win it. On your own when you win it. Wake up, look out the window, see the rose in the Bentley when you win it.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is in Uptown Charlotte, North Carolina at Bank of America Stadium. Just ahead, we'll decide the second entrant to next week's NFC title game. And we've got a great one in store, as it'll be the New Orleans Saints taking on the Carolina Panthers. Who will punch the fourth and final ticket to the conference championship round? We'll know soon enough as we are underway here on a January afternoon. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Now a timeout here, at least for the moment. Looks like one of the Saints is injured, shaken up on that last play. While they come out and take a look at him, we will step aside for just a moment. They start the drive with Cook. Give him three there on the first play of the game, and it's second down.
We've called a lot of games, but we don't normally talk about inside linebackers being that fleet of foot, do we?
No, he was able to get outside there to make that play.
Yeah, and you know what makes them faster? Their ability to read plays, understand what offenses are trying to do, and put themselves in proper position.
And they'll come up on a second and seven from the 27. Stroud. Looking for the out route here, and it's completed to Kirk. So about 5 yards down, the pitch and catch. And that'll leave him with a third and two. I think defensively you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that, you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch. Now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Faced with their first third down conversion opportunity and able to punch it through and pick it up on the ground.
And to me, doing it on the ground sends a different type of a message than throwing the football. And, you know, let's face it, we've done a lot of games together. How often have we seen third down turn into an automatic passing down no matter what the yard?
Yeah, and last thing you want, that opening drive to go three and out. You got everything scripted, lined up. Let's get some points on the board, and they're able to avoid that three and out.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
Flushed out right. That one complete downfield to Kirk. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 31-yard line. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
So, Charles, you look at this offense, you think about it, you got a rookie quarterback at the helm. You're in the divisional round of the playoffs here. That head of his just has to be spinning, doesn't it?
Well, normally you'd have to say yes, but I do think that the way things went last week, how he played the wild card win, how sensational he was, that'll stop his head from spinning. And now he's in a situation that's getting towards uncharted territory, because you've got Joe Flacco, Mark Sanchez, the only two rookies to win two playoff games in 1 year. He's trying to join that company, but it's not going to be easy to get it done.
Stroud off the play fake. And he's got it. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Isaiah Likely laying himself out in the end zone. And the Saints are on the board first here in this division round matchup. I'll let you do the analysis, partner, but with every touchdown pass this young quarterback throws and with the success that his team has had, I just continue to be more and more impressed.
Let's both do the analysis. Impressed, aren't we both?
Yeah.
I mean, and why shouldn't we be? We've seen him improve throughout the year. We've seen him settle in now, and you can see the confidence of the team has grown. His confidence has grown. I think that everyone around this guy feels good about what they've seen, and it's also safe for him when he's driving home to turn on Sports Talk Radio. He's okay.
Braxton Berrios selected to bring it out. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. They start things off with a carry by Gibbs here. And they'll get to him quickly here as he'll get a yard, just a yard to the 22.
Brandon, to me, what's important right here on this drive is for them to get at least 2 first downs. They've got to give their defense a chance to settle down, catch their breath a little bit after they give up a touchdown on the opening drive.
From the 22 now, here's 2nd and 9. Another run for Gibbs here. And he'll be upended here after a pickup of 3, getting it out to the 25. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Now a 3rd and 6. Now Pickett. Pass to the sideline and pulled in. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. And they're able to convert on 3rd with a solid gain of 23.
I know at the end of games, coaches always tell us that no one play won or lost a game. But this seems pretty important early, doesn't it? Their ability to pick up that first down on 3rd down, I thought that was key.
Well, you're already in the hole after the touchdown on the other side. How will you respond? We talk about that a lot. And they responded pretty well there. You go 3 and out, I think you give up a lot of momentum. You get down 2 scores, could be an entirely different game.
So they've got a nice drive going now. They're in good shape. What's interesting to me is they're also in that spot of the field where you would take a shot. Do you change that up just because you're down a touchdown?
On 1st and 10, here's Gibbs. A good gain of 9 before he's brought down at the 28.
A nice run here early on, and they'll take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber who runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
Ball on the 28-yard line. Here's 2nd down and a yard. Straight ahead with Gibbs here. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup, and that's all they needed to move the sticks.
2nd and 1, and people wanted to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the 1st down.
Off play action, Pickett. That's going to be caught. Touchdown. Dalton Kincaid, 26 yards. And the Panthers are able to match the opening drive touchdown against them with one of their own. Extra point up and good from Santoso. And we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Now this will be returned from deep in the end zone.
And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that. And Charles's defense, they were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another 1st and 10. Left side, Cook. It's a pretty strong running there as he'll take this across the 50 and down to the 44. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays.
And when you get into the divisional round of the playoffs, this is where having the ability to run the football is such an advantage. The defenses, they're generally going to be tougher the further you go along. So if you get something established up front, it's going to give you a great chance to move on.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the 1st down run, and it's 2nd and 4. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going, and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. But also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
Down the left sideline. Touchdown, New Orleans. James Cook, 38 yards. And the Saints have taken the lead.
Charles, every time that he makes one of these plays, I think the front office, they get a bigger and bigger collective smile, because they feel more confident that they have found their guy, their future at quarterback.
And they should feel that way. It's obvious he's a big part of why they have such a good record this season. You're right about the bright future as well, and by association, a bright future for the franchise, too.
Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. Berrios now from his end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go.
Well, certainly they'd rather have the scenario they had last time. Now, Charles, remember, they had the short field. They took it in the end zone. Now this is going to have to be a longer, more sustained drive if they want to get points.
Yeah, a little bit more of a quick strike opportunity last time by where they were on the field, and you're exactly right about that. But now, backed up a little bit. What's that old expression we love to use? Time to matriculate the ball down the field and try and do it again.
Going to be caught downfield by Dotson. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Through one quarter, 14-7 our score. The big play has him all the way out near midfield for a 1st and 10. Off the play fake, here's Pickett. It is taken in by Kincaid. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. 39 yards the distance covered on the catch and run. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on 1st and 10. Gibbs straight ahead. And power running here down to the 6-yard line.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Now a 2nd down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
I know every offense wants to start their snaps closer to the goal line, but it's actually harder to throw the ball in those situations. You throw into that tight coverage, you see what happens. Hard to get the ball in there.
Not enough space there. Lucky maybe that it wasn't intercepted. So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. Looking to throw, Pickett. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Malik Hooker. The defense looked geared up to stop the run, but obviously, Charles, they were ready for the pass, too.
Yeah, they were hoping they could catch everyone crashing and playing the run, but that was a very ill-advised throw right there. The opportunity, lost.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns. Fighting to get back to the goal line. I don't think he got there. He did not get back there. It's a safety.
The goal here is about getting any kind of positive yardage in this spot, because you don't care who, you don't care how. You just want to try and buy a little space and get away from your own end zone. But in this spot, the defense was all over that play and equally motivated to stick him with a safety.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw.
He gets this out wide to Gibbs.
And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 17 yards on the catch and run. It's a 1st down.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there. Getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out of the blitz, he's going to win that ball just about every time.
15 more yards there and quickly another 1st down. A perfect example right there, Charles, of why they love this rookie runner.
And think about how the NFL and the college games are meshing together more and more. You don't have to go to the NFL and learn a new set of skills. What you did in college often makes you ready for the NFL.
Going back to Gibbs on 1st down. And able to give one man the slip there as he works his way forward for about 3.
It went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a 2nd back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
Here's Pickett. Going underneath, Gibbs has it. And this is going to be another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Saints' 27-yard line. A solid gain of 15 yards and the sticks move.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time they pick up a 1st down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
A give right side for Gibbs, and he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority, because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Now a 2nd and 10. Pickett back to throw. This to the tight end, Kincaid. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. And a put him close to 100 yards receiving. He's at 98, and he's got a first down. Great mix of play calling so far. Three runs, three passes. All three passes have been completions. First and goal.
I think on defense now, you have to almost take a chance. Rely on your scouting. Pick a play you think they would run here and just load up for it and see what happens.
And from the 9, they get this to the 5-yard line.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on it before he could get much out of it.
Pickett, he'll look to throw it.
And he's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. Nick Bosa able to run him down for a loss of 12 that time.
Second goal, last thing you need to do is get pushed backwards to take a sack. But he couldn't find anywhere to go with the football. Had to eat it and ended up on the ground.
A big one coming in this divisional round playoff. Third and goal. Pickett will look to throw it here.
He's got it for a Panther touchdown.
Juju Smith-Schuster.
An 18-yard touchdown grab.
And the
extra point up and good from Santoso. And the lead is now 2.
Santoso now to send this one away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone.
And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started.
And things have changed since the last time they had it. The safety led to the touchdown. So now they find themselves behind as they begin with a first and 10.
A good pickup there, 21 yards.
First down, New Orleans.
First and 10, it's Stroud.
Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
On second down, Cook.
And strong running there as he's across midfield and down to the 49. 46 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point.
That was good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
And they'll throw it with Stroud here, first and 10.
Eluding the pressure right.
And that is incomplete. Well, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
This is certainly a team that has proven it likes to target its backs through the air, and defensively, they were aware of that and certainly were prepared on that throw.
Come on. Here's second and 10.
Give to Cook out of the gun. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
He had to fight for every yard on that run. Shook himself free of the tackle and kept fighting. He got the rest of the defense closing in on him. That's the kind of effort he'll take every single time.
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half.
Now Stroud. Oh, tries to force it in, and it's intercepted.
Eddie Jackson picks it. Down the sideline he goes. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick 6. They'll hit the touchdown.
Extra point try now for Santoso.
and that makes it a 9-point game. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. Well, not much time remains here in this first half. We'll see if they can get something out of this drive, at least a field goal. They could certainly use it, down by two scores. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down. Stroud to throw it. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
The time he wanted to get that ball downfield, but nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it up to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. And Stroud now to throw. He's got his target. That's complete. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. On first down, here's Stroud. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
For the rookie quarterback out there, you're definitely going to find out how he handles adversity, because this one so far hasn't gone according to plan. He's got to fight through it and show him what he's made of.
The throwing again is Stroud. Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Jack Campbell with a pick. And he's giving his guys a shot for late points as they will take over in range for a field goal or maybe more.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at the 19-yard line.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Back to throw, Pickett. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Tyreek Stevenson picks it off. And nothing comes of this last-ditch attempt at points as time will run out on this first half. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. And no fireworks to start the half. This will be a touchback. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they're in the position they expected to be in. They've got the lead, home crowd behind them, and they're looking toward making that next step in these playoffs.
And I think a key for them is to put together some good, long, extended drives. Work the run in a little more with that big offensive line. I'm not saying get away from throwing the football. That's still working, but they run it more effectively. They may get even bigger plays in the passing game.
Second and six, just inside the 30. Pickett setting up the screen. This is Gibbs, and he gets this one just short of the 11 yards and a Panther first down.
When you have success throwing the football, the old cliche becomes true. The playbook opens up wide, and these screen passes, they become even more difficult to stop.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. Second and 10.
Pickett now to throw off the play fake. And he's taken down here by the Saints.
They dial up the corner blitz that time, and it delivers to the tune of a 9-yard loss.
They tried to go with a little play action there, but nobody on the defensive side bit.
Yeah, they adjusted in time and in a big way and ultimately got the sack. On offense, sometimes you're running play action just to set up a certain blocking technique. In this case, none of it worked.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw.
Into the hands of Smith-Schuster on the crossing pattern.
14 yards is the pickup there, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
There's another example of what defensive coaches constantly preach, not allowing any run after the catch. They gave up a few more yards than they wanted to, but they were able to get him down quickly and force a fourth down.
And here's Morstead now as he sends this one away. And this will depend on the spot as it sails out of bounds, and they'll say it sailed out at the 10-yard line. The field position game, such an overlooked facet, Charles, of an NFL game, but this offense, they're going to be pinned back. What an ideal punt.
An ideal punt, and it leads to that term complementary football, because them doing that puts their defense in a great spot, doesn't it? Gives them a chance, if they want to be aggressive, try and maybe get a safety out of this whole thing, it puts them in that position.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Oh, that was a thing of beauty right there. Look at how quick those blockers fired off the line once the ball was snapped. That was an O-line on a mission, all in sync, and the defense is lucky that play only picked up 5 yards.
Here's a second and five. Here's Cook again.
And a short gain across the 15 to the 17-yard line. It'll be a pick up of a couple, and it leaves him with a third and three.
Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first.
A 10th carry in the game for Cook.
75 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night.
Inside 4 minutes to go, third quarter.
Stroud to the air on first and 10. Got his man, it's Jonathan Mingo.
And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. Had a little arc on it. He's got to find a way to get his head around and make a play on the football.
And they'll go play action here with Stroud. He's got Mingo.
And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10.
Back to the ground, Cook. And they get to him quickly here as he's stopped right around the 13. Eddie Jackson with a tackle.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Here's Stroud.
And he's got it. Touchdown, Saints.
Jonathan Mingo
from 13 yards out.
And the Saints go coast to coast and finish the drive off with 6 points.
And remember, partner, that's a rookie quarterback back there. Apparently, he's getting the hang of this NFL thing pretty quickly.
At 3 touchdown passes. You're right. He looks comfortable. What are they doing? Anything in particular?
Well, they keep talking about making sure they're giving him plays that fit his talents and also maybe shrinking the playbook a little bit. They did tell us that. Bottom line, he's really good.
Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off.
Berrios going to bring this out of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs. Run some plays, run some clock. Allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
Working out of the gun, it's Pickett. Finds Gibbs on the check down. Just a gain of a couple there. And now third down and six to go.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
Here's third and six. Now Pickett. And hitting Juju on the slant. That he won't quite make it. He needed six. He got about five. Fourth down. Here's Thomas Morstead now as he'll kick it away for the second time. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And this one sails out of bounds. I think it'll be inside the 25. It will. 24-yard line is where they'll spot it. The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you score once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. A shotgun snap to Stroud. This is caught. It's Kirk. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. A gain there of 30 big ones.
We have seen big plays from both quarterbacks throughout this game, and there's another one right there. Going back and forth, almost like two excellent guitar soloists trying to top each other with each additional play.
Now here's a throw. It's complete. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. A gain of eight there on the play, and it'll be second and a couple. From the gun, it's a give to Cook. And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. One quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. And we're back now in Charlotte. It's been a good one so far, just a two-point game here as we get set for quarter number four. Come on. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Again, it's Cook. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. It was Harrison Smith there up from his safety spot to make the play behind the line.
I know they've got to be careful not to go to the well too often, but it's a fine line, isn't it? Because sometimes if you've got success, you want to just keep pounding away.
But no success there. They rallied quickly on the defensive end. Play action. Here's Stroud out to his left. A short throw there to Strange. They'll give him 4 yards there. And third and eight now.
Time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played very well because it was a drag route. And he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Stroud off the play fake. Sliding out of the pocket. And off balance throw there, and it's going to end up being complete.
The coverage we just saw break out on third down. Defense, blanketed the field with extra defensive backs and speed, unable to find an open hole to complete that pass.
And his kick is good, and they have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. So he waited on the
the sideline for his first chance in the ball game, and it didn't come until the fourth quarter, but he connects there. A big one to give him the lead.
Boy, you talk about coming in cold. I don't care how many times you kick it into a net. You're not really ready when you go out there and all that beef is coming at you trying to block the kick. Big spot, and he delivers.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And this could be the defining moment of their season, all hyperbole aside. You're trailing here in the fourth quarter, the divisional round. And they need to come up with something as they get this drive started. Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit, but get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
The offense on third down tonight, 2 for 5 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 2. Pickett, he'll look to throw it. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. That'll put him north of 100 yards receiving now in this divisional round game. And it's a first down. They run the play fake. Here's Pickett. Throw out wide, going to be incomplete.
And when you've thrown as many interceptions as he has in this one, you definitely start getting a little hesitant to throw the ball out wide because that's prime pick six territory. That time, he made sure the only guy who was going to catch it was sitting in the third row.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Trying the left side with Gibbs. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards. Back to the 33. He'll wind up losing 3. And now it's 3rd down.
There's no question that coming into this game, this defense was pretty vocal about his desire to take this running back out of his game. And all that pregame woofing has turned into results.
3rd down and 13. Looking to throw. Pickett. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints' 44-yard line. A big play there as they get the conversion on 3rd and 13. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's 1st and 10. Hand off now to Gibbs. And a good push up front, and he's able to narrow his way down inside the 40. 62 yards rushing for him in the ball game now on 14 carries.
And they like this drive a little bit better than that part. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because we remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
Off play action, Pickett. He gets this out wide to Gibbs. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 12 more yards there and another first down.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and we watch him drop for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
On the give, here's Gibbs. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Jahmyr Gibbs, an 18-yard touchdown run. And the Panthers have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter. And This has definitely been a back-and-forth affair, and now they have the lead here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, and they gave up the field goal on that last drive, as we remember, but it felt like their offense told them, don't worry about it. We've got your backs. We'll come back with a touchdown of our own, and they did.
And it is incomplete, so they can't convert for two. And now the lead stays at five. Santoso now to send this one away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. We certainly have a good one on our hands. They're trailing after that last touchdown, but now a chance for this offense to try to snag that lead right back here in the fourth quarter.
The result, only 4 yards there on the play, and it'll be second down.
A gain of four. It's now second and six.
Back to throw. Here's Stroud. A short one there, caught by Likely.
Yeah, this will be a gain of five as he gets it to the 30.
Right there, he rose to the occasion late in a close game.
It's something he thought about, dreamed about, and worked on throughout his career. Because in these types of situations, he wasn't going to allow extra coverage to keep him from getting the football.
Here we go, third and one. Gut check time on both sides. Stroud out of the gun here. Escaping the pressure right.
And Stroud wisely slides down safely after picking up the first down.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive.
Plenty of time. All three timeouts still remain. Here's first and 10 now.
They'll try the middle with Cook. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
Not a bad game there, and it's okay to still run the football in this situation, but you got to be careful to not take too much time off the clock.
Stroud to throw it.
Completes it to Kirk over the middle. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 41-yard line.
Now you're right on the edge of field goal range. You've still got time, but get up to the line of scrimmage and get set.
They'll come up first and 10 here. Now Stroud.
Swinging this out wide here for Cook.
And he gets his down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. Looked like a pretty good, safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy out in the flat.
And so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about, in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down. A nice safe throw and a good one.
And he works his way free all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone.
And now all of a sudden, the shoe's kind of on the other foot. Maybe you pull the reins back here a bit?
Yeah, a little bit, because you got to make sure that you don't score too quickly.
All three timeouts still at their disposal. Here's first and 10 now.
They run with Cook. He's been busy tonight. Inside the 10 at the 8. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
Stroud.
And he's got his man in stride, complete. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the
What a game this has been, and what a drive that was, Charles, to take the lead here late in the fourth quarter.
And, partner, that's a job well done by everyone, from the players to the guys calling the plays. And if I may introduce just one downside to the mix, might be a little bit too much time left. Enough on the clock for a final last-ditch effort to try and steal this win away.
And now incomplete. They can't convert. So they tried to bump the lead up to a field goal. Instead, it stays at one here in the fourth. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. And the fair catch taken. No time will come off the clock. And they will begin this critical drive at the 25-yard line. Here's first and 10. Looking to throw here. Pickett. That is caught. Kincaid with it.
The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts, as he'll stop it with 27 seconds showing on the clock.
Well, this offense still has the one timeout here, remember. First and 10. This taken in by Kincaid. He's going to go with the first down. So an ideal set of circumstances there. They move the chains, and they save that final timeout. Pickett to throw.
And this one incomplete. So the clock stopped now with 20 seconds remaining. There have been quite a few plays they might look back on and say, we really have hurt ourselves, and that was another example.
And this is late game execution. Everything on the line, so it all has to come together properly. The throw's made. Where's the catch? Got to catch in that spot.
This to the tight end, Kincaid.
And he's across for the touchdown, and it's likely the game stages.
Charles, that drive was perfect. Methodical, executed so well, and they grabbed that lead with almost no time left for a last gasp from the other side.
No way you could have drawn up a better final drive, because not only did they keep their eyes on the end zone, they made sure they bled the clock out as well and denied their opponent a chance to respond. That's just terrific situational football to end this one.
The Panther offense staying put. They'll go for two.
Pickett to throw.
And now it's incomplete. So they can't convert for two, but they still have the lead as we get toward the end of the fourth.
Santoso now to send this one away. And a fair catch taken. No time will come off the clock. And they will begin this critical drive at the 25-yard line. This is first and 10. Here's Stroud. Crossing route, and finds Likely.
So there's one big play followed by the timeout as we're under 10 seconds to go. And now how do you play it offensively? We'll find out.
Here's first down. To throw it, Stroud. He'll air this one out for Kirk.
And that's going to be incomplete. Now one more shot at it. Obviously, again, they've got to go for the end zone.
Well, we've seen it happen before. How about Aaron Rodgers throughout his career? He seems to pull it off about every other week. But if I'm the defense, I'm rushing the quarterback and making him move away from his throwing arm. That makes it a little bit tougher to get it downfield.
One final shot for C.J. Stroud.
He's going to try and go deep again. And it's incomplete, so their final drive comes up empty, and with that, the ball game is over.
The Panthers' season will press on, as we say, so long, everybody.